as an engine lathe. The basic components of the lathe are the headstock, which is this piece here where all of your gear selectors are. And all these mean different things. Here you have a RPM selector. The A, B, and C located here on this one dictates which RPM you're in, along with these lines and the position of the actual handle. You also have feed selector, and the feed is determined by this gear and these gears in combination, along with this one here. And you can see how they have charts to match up the letters and numbers of the gears. Another component of the lathe is the carriage, which controls all your movement in longitudinal and back and forth in latitude. You also can have an angular movement here. This is your cross slide, which controls the lateral. This is your compound rest that controls your angular movement. It is graduated right here. If you want to zoom in, you can see the graduations. And it will actually spin 360 degrees, but it's only graduated for 180. Also located in the carriage is your automatic feed lever, and this will control the longitudinal and lateral automatic feed. This is your half nut, which is only used when cutting threads. We also have an emergency stop button, like the saw. If you mash this, it kills all the power to the lathe, just like it does on the saw. And here, this is what controls the chuck and the spindle, and cuts the spindle on. And then you can reverse the spindle. This is the chuck. Most lathes come with a 3-jaw chuck. We also use 4-jaw chucks that have jaws that move independently. The 3 jaws, all the jaws move at the same time with the turn of a chuck key. And the chuck key fits in this square slot here. That's what you say to tighten up your work. On the carriage, we also have a tool post which contains your tool holder and your tool. You can adjust the height of the tool and the actual angle of the tool. We also have a tailstock, and the tailstock is used to either for hole making operations, for drilling, reaming, tapping, or just holding work between centers or stabilizing long shafts. In addition to that, the lead screw and the feed screw, they turn independently of each other on this model. The lead screw is used when threading, and that's what the half nut lever locks into. The feed screw is what is used to dictate how fast it's feeding. Again, we're going back to the headstock where all the feed information is located and the feed selectors. So that dictates how fast it feeds along that shaft. The ways here is what everything sits on. The bed is what the ways are located. Ways need to be cleaned. You always just take a rag or a brush and wipe away the chips. It's important to have them well lubricated so they don't rust. And if they get pitted, they can get pitted from chips. And if they get pitted, it's a very expensive process to revitalize those ways. And that's the engine lathe.